Hello everyone, iSchool Tech here. Now, iOS 17.2 just released to everyone after several weeks of beta testing, and so in this video we're going to be taking a look to see how it performs, what battery life is like, animations, what bugs have been fixed, what bugs still remain, as well as several other things. Anyways, if you haven't already, make sure to hit that subscribe button down below for more content just like this, as I do it for every iOS release, and let's waste no extra time and get straight into it. Alright, so kicking things off with the general performance of iOS 17.2, I have nothing but satisfactory things to say pretty much in this entire section, actually. Performance has remained largely the same. Occasionally, I'll notice maybe like a fraction of a second increase in performance, but it's pretty negligible. Regardless, though, this is still good news considering A, it wasn't a decrease, B, the performance was already fantastic, so I have no complaints in that area. And with animations, I do actually have a couple of good things to say. So iOS 17.2 seems to have completely eliminated all of the micro, or actually I'd prefer to call it nano stuttering, because it was very, 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 very minimal stuttering that would happen only so often. But I would notice it, you know, you pick it up. And so, for example, when swiping down to the notification center, swiping back up, occasionally there would be this slight stutter. That has been fixed and completely like just disappeared in this release. Very pleased about that. Same thing with entering Spotlight search. Occasionally there would be this ever so slight delay, just like this looked choppy almost. That hasn't appeared once at all on 17.2. And even better, for the first time in I don't even know how long, the control center no longer stutters in any way, shape, or form when, you know, opening it up. This is groundbreaking, complete innovation. It is wild. The control center, I cannot tell you how many times since earlier iOS 17, iOS 16, iOS, even iOS 15, I think it started around iOS 15, there was just be this occasional stutter when opening up the control center, and it has seemed to be finally fixed. I've noticed no stuttering at all in the control center. So that's great news. Fantastic. Now, moving on to RAM management, again, no difference, at least no discernible difference here compared to previous iOS 17 releases. So if you were having issues with that before, it is likely that you may still have issues with this release. And if you weren't having any issues with it prior into iOS 17.2, you should be fine. So pretty much all good news all around in that entire area. All right, so battery life, my favorite segment of the videos. Nothing but good news, actually, so this kind of is my favorite segment right now. iOS 17.2 has had the best battery life by far of any previous iOS 17 release for me. I haven't seen battery life this good on my 14 Pro Max since earlier iOS 16 as well, which is fantastic. And I've noticed the same across the board, for example, with my iPad Pro 12.9 inch as well. Of course, that video is out now, so you can watch that if you want to know more about that right here. But yeah, battery life, at least on my 14 Pro Max, has been fantastic. Nothing bad to report. Now keep in mind, there's a couple of things. Number one, if you do update and immediately notice, oh no, why is this overheating, or why is my battery draining? This is normal, or it can be normal. After you update to a new iOS release, your iPhone has to go through a process called indexing. And basically, in layman's terms, what this is just some background processes running in the file system in the background. This can lead to overheating and it can lead to battery drain. Should resolve within the first 48 hours or so. If it continues on, let me know in the comments below and I'll definitely get back to you, because that is quite interesting and you may just be very unlucky with iOS 17.2. But that's assuming you notice indexing at all, because personally, I usually never notice it, but just to keep in mind, it can happen. Now, anyway, battery life, it's just been much better. But with my 15 Pro, I'm very curious to see, because with iOS 17.1.2, it has actually been better for me, noticeably better than 17.1.1. This is interesting to me because iOS 17.1.2 only brought two security fixes and that was it. I'm curious to see, now that I have 17.2 installed on this, how it's going to perform over the next week. It will be the same as the rest of the devices. If it is, I will let you all know in my 1 week later iOS 17.2 review, coming, of course, a week from now, if you couldn't tell. So stay tuned for that. Of course, that means subscribe down below with notifications enabled to stay up to date and know exactly when that drops. But anyway, overall, battery life has been fantastic. I cannot say it enough, considering how many times I've already said it. It is just truly amazing. Now for overheating, it has been the same as previous iOS 17 releases. I have not noticed any overheating at all on any devices. Not that I'd expect to notice on my iPad, but on my iPhones that I've tested it on, I've noticed no overheating whatsoever, including during the update and right after. So that is fantastic news. So there are still a couple of remaining bugs left with iOS 17, and pretty much all of them have been here since early iOS 16. Now, none of them are anything huge. They're just very annoying, and they have been there for a long time. The first one has to do with the control center. When swiping down to the access the control center or interacting with any of the platters, you may notice that the home controls actually just flash. Like, the platters just disappear and reappear. I don't know why, but they do this, and it's quite annoying. It has not been fixed, and honestly, I don't think it will ever be fixed until the control center is redesigned. But it's there. The second thing also has to do with the control center. Occasionally, when opening up the control center and then closing it after use, the status bar indicators for Wi-Fi, battery, and cellular will freeze lower than they should, and then suddenly just appear slightly higher on the display where they're supposed to be. This is very hard to replicate on camera because it does not happen that often, but it does happen, and some of you may have seen this before. It's just a strange bug, but it's there. The next up, you probably guessed it, has to do with the notification center. In the notification center, when you have notifications, or even with the no notifications text, when swiping up, they're just so glitched. It's crazy. They just jump all over the place in no order, and the text is no better. It's just this really strange glitch that has not been fixed, and it has been over a year at this point. Other than that, iOS 17.2 at least, I haven't noticed really any other bugs. It is really, really, really stable in terms of bugs. Those are the only issues I've noticed so far. Of course, in my 1 week later, in a week from now, I will have an update if there are any more bugs I find in the meantime. But for now, those are the only issues I've noticed, and they're not really iOS 17 specific issues either. So that's pretty good. Now, as for bug fixes in iOS 17.2, there is only one listed in the release notes provided by Apple, and that is fixes an issue that may prevent wireless charging in certain vehicles. Now, if you don't already know, there was a lot of wireless charging issues in vehicles from several different manufacturers, and so this update does claim to fix that. So we will see. If you do still experience issues with that, make sure to report it to Apple, either using the feedback app or online. But other than that, there are no fixes besides that one listed in this changelog. All right, everyone, so that is iOS 17.2. Now, with quite a few new features, as well as some bug fixes and general improvements, even if only slight, across the board, iOS 17.2 actually makes for a very good update. Now, whether or not you should update depends on just a couple of things, such as what iOS version you're currently on. If you're currently on iOS 16 and you've been waiting to update to iOS 17, I'd actually say that now is a good time to update. And of course, if you're already on an iOS 17 release, I would just go ahead and hit that download install button to get the new features as well as some extra bug fixes. Anyways, that is all I have for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, show me by leaving a like down below. And if you haven't already, make sure to hit that subscribe button with notifications enabled to stay up to date with more content just like this. Anyways, thank you all so much for watching. See you next time.